The time is 9:51 a.m. August 29, Sunday 2021. The news headline. What Buhari has done to bandits worse than what he did to IPOP, the presidency. The news in full. Senior Special Assistant on Media and Publicity to President Muhammadu Buhari, Malam Garba Shehu, has insisted that what President Muhammadu Buhari has done to bandits is worse than the treatment meted on the indigenous people of Biafra IPOP group. Shehu, in an interview with BBC Pidgin on Saturday, said the notion held by Nigerians that the Buhari-led administration was given preferential treatment in the handling of matters concerning bandits and other people posing threats to the nation's stability were far from the truth, as the president was dealing them a fatal blow. Reacting to a question on why the federal government has not declared bandits and criminal herdsmen terrorists and outlawed them, Shehu said, "What the Buhari administration has done to the arms-wielding bandits is worse than being declared as terrorists. Do you know that there is a subsisting order by the president that any arms-wielding AK-47 bandits should be shot on sight? Comparing to the handling of bandits with the handling of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOP, Shehu said, while there is a subsisting order by the president to shoot any bandits on sight, there is no such order against the proscribed Igbo separatist group. I am saying yes. Indigenous people of Biafra, IPOP has been proscribed by law of the land. There is no shoot on sight order on IPOP. There is nothing to suggest that these bandits are treated preferentially," he added. Shehu also said progress had been recorded in dealing with bandits and terrorists. The Nigerian Air Force is busy bombing locations. The military is there on ground, exchanging fire for fire, taking them out in undress. That is certainly not treating them, the bandits, lightly. It is a matter of time. They will be substantially reduced and Nigeria state will be saved all over again. For instance, Boko Haram are surrendering today in thousands. This did not just happen. Before President Buhari assumed office, many Nigerians could not worship on Fridays. Mosques were being bombed. On Sunday, churches were being bombed, motor parks and public gatherings too. But today, everyone can testify that such do not happen. The time is 9:54 a.m. Sunday, August 29, 2021. The analysis. Subsequent to the callings of the citizens of Nigeria to the federal government about declaring bandits as terrorists and leaving the IPOB or other agitators out of their target. You know, sometimes ago, the civil rights advocacy group, Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria, has asked the federal government to declare as terrorists bandits drowning Nigeria Air Force, you know, downing Nigeria Air Force jet, killing and maiming citizens all over the country. And the group also urged the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami San, to leave separatists alone and ensure the prosecution of suspected bandits and Boko Haram members in the custody of security agencies. You know, the national coordinator of Uriwa, Emmanuel Umubiko, and group's media affairs director, Zainab Yusuf, made this known in a statement on one Sunday titled "Uriwa Cautions AGF on Yoruba Nation / IPOP." The group was reacting to a statement by the AGF office that the government might proscribe Yoruba Nation group just like it outlawed the indigenous people of Biafra in 2017. In a Sunday Punch also reported at the time that Malami Special Assistant on Media and Public Relations, Umagwandu, said that the federal government would explore all options within the context of the law, including proscription, to ensure a peaceful and united Nigeria. reacting, Uriwa said it was unjust that the government proscribed IPOB and might outlaw the Yoruba Nation separatist group, but failed to declare bandits ravaging parts of the country as terrorists. You know, the group accused the government of President Major Muhammadu Buhari that they are being so sectional and carpeted the federal government for failing to declare as terrorists the armed militia in the forest of Zamfara State, who shot down a military jet belonging to the Nigerian force some time ago. And also in line with this, Yuma actually tells, some time ago in July, Yuma actually told the federal government of Nigeria that they should leave the IPOB alone and they should fight the banditry and also insurgency. You know, a former military governor of Kaduna State, Colonel Abubakar Umar, on Wednesday knocked down the All Progressive Congress and the federal government led by President Major General Muhammadu Buhari retired for giving undue attention to the arrest of Kanu than the banditry and kidnapping ravaging the country. Umar argued that it was disturbing that rather than concentrating on insecurity, threatening to cripple the country, the Buhari regime was celebrating the arrest of IPOB leader and also looking for a way to expatriate that of the Yoruba agitator, Sunday Adejiemo, popularly known as Sunday Igboho, leaving aside a whole lot of challenges that our nation is facing in terms of security. Recall that Umar lost his commission in the Nigerian Army as a result of his principal stance on the annulment of the June 12, 1993 presidential election and claimed to be won by the late Chief MKO Abiola. He said on the Wednesday that the federal government must go beyond the arrest of Kanu and pay more attention on more security challenges threatening to cripple Nigeria. And as a result of all this clamor, the senior special assistant to President Muhammadu Buhari on media and publicity, Garba Shehu, has insisted that what President Muhammadu Buhari has done to bandits is worse than the treatment meted out on the IPOB, known as the Indigenous People of Biafra. You know, in his interview with BBC Pidgin on Saturday, he said that the notion held by Nigerians and this human rights group and some other citizens, well-known prominent member of citizens of the country, is actually posing threats on the nation's stability because it is far from the truth, as the president is dealing with these terrorists more than we can imagine, because he is giving to them a fatal blow. You know, reacting to the question on why the federal government has not declared bandits and criminal headsmen as terrorists and also outlawed them the same way they did to the IPOB, he said that what the Buhari administration has done is more than that. Number one, he said, he was asking a question that, do Nigerians know, are they aware that the president actually ordered that for any bandit that is spotted using AK-47, they should be shot on sight? Meanwhile, the indigenous people of Biafra who were outlawed, there was no order relating to that to shoot any one of them on sight, even if caught with firearms. He said that the progress has been recorded in dealing with bandits and terrorists, even more than just tagging them or declaring them as terrorists. He said the Nigerian Air Force is busy bombing all locations belonging to them, and in thousands, the Boko Haram are surrendering today, which has not been happening because back then, Fridays for Muslims worshipping in the mosque and Sundays for Christians worshipping in churches, as at then, was not like that because they keep on bombing everywhere, the motor parks and the likes and any public gathering. But today, it is not like that. The time is 10 a.m. Good morning.